If you played around with ChatGPT, you know that the story of 2022 was AI. Now, every major tech company is clamoring to get a piece of that pie.
But why is big tech so focused on AI right now? And who is best positioned to win?
Let's dive into it. I'm Stephanie Wong, tech veteran, engineer, and creator.
And I'm Bertrand Seguin, founder of App Economy Insights.
OpenAI's ChatGPT went viral, and now people are using it to cheat in school and write cleaner code. It proved that consumers, not just AI researchers, want it now. And it's a perfect example of what startups with funding and fast launches can ignite.
And now, the tech industry feels a fire lit under them. It was like the starting flag at a race, and now's the official AI arms race. The AI industry is expected to grow from $400 billion in 2022 to $1.4 trillion by 2029.
This is the start of a three-part series where we evaluate the biggest players in AI among hyperscalers, consumer tech, and semiconductors. We'll cover what they're doing well and some risks that could stunt their growth.
First off, AI is a broad term, and companies can be developing or supporting AI in different ways. I like how Andreessen Horowitz mapped out the generative AI tech stack to help us better analyze the market. The stack can be divided into three layers. Applications that integrate AI models into user-facing product, models that power AI products, and infrastructure like cloud vendors and hardware manufacturers.
Before we go any further, remember to hit that subscribe button so we can keep bringing you free content and help you on your tech, business, and investing journey. One of the first places to look is hyperscalers, otherwise known as big tech. Big cloud providers are a good place to start. They offer AI from soup to nuts, or should I say chips to apps.
First, we have Microsoft. For context, the cloud made up 41% of Microsoft's revenue in Q4 2022. You might have heard that Microsoft invested $1 billion in OpenAI in 2019 and made their cloud, Azure, OpenAI's exclusive cloud provider. And now, Microsoft is expected to invest an additional $10 billion. This is on top of other AI investments, like GitHub Copilot, an AR pair programmer that uses the OpenAI Codex model to support developers. So they have their pawns in many parts of the stack. One is cloud platforms and GPUs on Azure for B2B customers. Azure OpenAI servers so team can build AI models. One is apps like ChatGPT being integrated into the Bing search engine. And then we have reports that ChatGPT eventually is coming to Microsoft productivity apps. So we're seeing them incorporate AI in a lot of facets of their business.
The thing is that investments like OpenAI are incredibly expensive. But given that OpenAI appears to be in the running to be the AI epoch's top growing company, that means that Microsoft is investing in the infrastructure of that epoch. Bing, meanwhile, is like the Mac versus iPhone business. Yes, it contributes a fair bit of revenue, but it's still a very small fraction of the dominant player. But if incorporating ChatGPT-like results gives them the chance to gain massive market share, I think it's a bet well worth making. The trick to bringing AI into their productivity apps will be to imitate the success of GitHub Copilot, which figured out how to be a help instead of a nuisance. Remember Clippy?
Oof, Clippy was a struggle.
All right, next up, Alphabet, parent company of Google. Alphabet uses AI in virtually every facet of its business, from ad pricing to content promotion, Gmail spam filters, Google Assistant, and more. This isn't a surprise. I mean, Google has long been a leader in using ML and has offered that technology as a service through Google Cloud, which, by the way, makes up 10% of overall revenue in Q4 of 2022. Google Cloud offers NVIDIA GPUs and their custom-developed TPUs built to accelerate ML workloads. TPUs have gained traction in the Stable Diffusion community and in some pretty large cloud deals. They package their custom ML models like translation and natural language processing via APIs for B2B customers. They also open source TensorFlow, a popular ML library for developers, and they're leading in AI research. Google invented the transformer, the key technology under the latest AI models. It's also the parent company of AI research company DeepMind, And plus, they own autonomous vehicle company Waymo.
Back in 2014, Google moved from being a mobile-first to an AI-first company. They are making strides in AI, and there are claims that its image generation capabilities are better than DALL-E, and their chat will be better than ChatGPT. But it remains to be seen until they land a product on the market. The key will be their ability to productize their generative AI research fast and beat out Microsoft and AWS in their cloud arm.
Yes, so the clock is ticking.
Now let's talk about Amazon. Amazon has built AI into targeted advertisement, search algorithm, and AWS. For context, AWS was 14% of Amazon's revenue, but it drives all the profit. So let's break it down by the AI tech stack. Amazon unveiled its new warehouse robotic arm called Sparrow, which uses computer vision and AI and is capable of moving products of various sizes prior to boxing. AWS offers a wide range of AI services, including access to GPUs, advanced text analytics, automated code reviews, and chatbots. On the consumer-facing side, AI helps with recommendations on Amazon.com or Alexa, which is another popular virtual assistant. They are doing more with voice-enabled shopping and Amazon Go stores.
Similar to the challenges all the big three tech companies are facing, I think it depends on how useful these products end up being in the real world. A lot of AWS's efforts to date have been focused on its Graviton CPUs, but the company could build dedicated hardware for models like Stable Diffusion. Still, AWS is hedging its bets. It's staked itself out as a major partner with NVIDIA, arguably the biggest AI hardware chip manufacturer to date.
Amazon hasn't been known as the lead innovator in AI, but they've been pursuing AI across the company for years. It's time for them to ramp up across the cloud to secure their stake as the highest grossing provider.
Well, there you have it. The top AI companies getting into every nook and cranny of the AI ecosystem. We'll see which will be the fastest to market. As history tells us, first to market isn't always the winner, but in the case of big tech, it can be.
We still have two more videos in this three-part series. Next, we'll be covering consumer tech companies, Tesla, Meta, and Apple. They are doing more in AI than you might think.
Yes, so I am really excited. I mean, we're talking robots and VR. So comment below with your thoughts and predictions and subscribe to our channel for more videos about tech, finance, and investing from us.